Chancellor said the Amity students are the most energetic here in this society. Can I feel you, please? All right. Thank you. Do you want to be a successful here, or you just want to have a certificate and go back home and sleep tonight? Successful? Well, Dr. Abdullah said he, you know, you have to dream of Ferrari. I dreamt earlier of Toyota and got a bicycle. So be careful of what you dream, right? So be careful. By all means, I'm giving a great pleasure to be part of this great ceremony. And the great university is one of highly respected global brand, I would say, and they really made a difference in the education in the UAE. Your Highness, Sheikh Ahmed bin Saeed Maktoum, you're one of the great leaders whom I admire personally. The way how Emirates Airline took off to the sky because of the great leaders we have here. Those who are very authentic and they lead with a great example. So we're really proud of our leadership, the way how the country is being moved around. I give my full support to the Amity University of their mission, and I fully accepted the Honorable PhD. And by the way, this is the fifth PhD as a Honorable I have received throughout the 20 years of my life. This is the fifth one I have received. I have received two from the USA and one from the University of Somalia during the starvation. I've done a lot of mission in Somalia, and one from Delhi, it was last year. So I'm happy, this is the fifth in my life. I've got two quick messages for the student here. If you want to be a successful, and you did say that you want to be a successful tonight, I will give you three P's. And you can be successful throughout your life, whether it's your marriage life, it's your business life, it's your professional life, it's your personal life. The first one is the first P, is being positive. You have to be proud of yourself. You have to stay positive whatever happened to you. Just keep reminding you, just keep feeding your mind, your body, your soul, that I'm a very positive person. The second, patient. Never rush to a judgment. You have to be patient. Be patient in life. The first 20 years of your life is about teaching and learning. The second 20 years of your life is about earning. So you go from learning to earning. And then the rest of your life is about legacy, finding something great that you need to do. So the first, again, staying positive. Positivity is very important. Second is being patient. You have to appreciate the time factor. And the third, persistent. Never give up. When people think of you that you're crazy, you're doing something really lousy, and something will lead you to a death, something will lead you to a failure, never listen to them. Never listen to them. Keep moving forward. Keep pushing forward. This is about resistance. The second piece of advice I want to give you tonight, and please write it down, because this is going to really change the whole life. You have to be a dreamer. You have to be passionate. Well, in English language, when you talk about passion and dream, they sound very similar. It's just like when you talk about marketing and sales. They sound similar, but there's a big difference here. Being a dreamer is that you have a vision. You have something that you're chasing in life, a moving target. And it keeps changing from time to time. You achieve one, you move to the second, and to the third, and to this. This is the human cycle. This is how we are built, to be a dreamer, chasing our dream. And the dream usually sits in the mind. It's on the upper side of the human, sits on the mind. Now, the second important point I want to emphasize here is about how to be passionate about something. Passion is about love. Passion, what's drive you emotionally to do something in this life? What makes you to do something good? We call this passion. So you have to be passionate about what you do. And the passion usually sits in the heart. So if you have your heart and you have your mind, both of them, they work in synergization together. They produce authenticity. They give you a direction in this life. They give you a true north. You know where are you hitting to. You don't need someone to guide you, to coach you. You already know, driven by your gut, your personal feelings, that I have this internally. That compass can, can lead me to. It's not about speedometer. It's about a direction. If I ask each one of you in this lovely gathering here to point the magnetic north, everybody will be pointing in the same direction, because we have smartphones. We have a magnetic phone, it will lead us to the direction. But if I ask each one of you to bond the true north he or she feels in this life, believe me, we start to point finger at each other, and somebody may shoot to the sky. We feel that is the true north. So that is what I want to say. Once again, I'm really very happy and humbled to be here and receiving such a prestigious, honorable PhD from this lovely, which I have all the respect to this place and to this university. And once again, thank you very much. See you at the top always. Thank you.